How's it going, everyone? Welcome to a new playthrough of Hotline Miami. I've actually played this game before, a lot actually, all the way back in 2019, around Christmas of 2019. The whole reason why I'm even playing this game again is because they released a new PS5 collection, and I just decided to play it again, because I actually really like this game. It's very challenging. I've struggled with this game, both the first and second game, severely, but I just really wanted to play it again because of the new collection. And I have not played it in a long time, so without further ado, let's just get right into it. Okay, so let's start with the intro. Okay. Yeah, this is Jacket's apartment. Okay. You have one new message. Hi, this is Tim at the bakery. The cookies that you ordered should be delivered by now. A list of ingredients are included. Make sure that you read them carefully. Click. Okay. It is the chicken mask. The target is a briefcase discretion of its essence. Leave target at point F32 inside the dumpster. Failure is not an option. We'll be watching you. Okay. Well, let's just go right into that. Vibration is indeed rewarding. Okay. Go. Shit. Oh, good damn, we got up. Is this like a tire iron? I don't know, maybe it's a golf club. See, the one problem, oh my god, with the first game is that the enemies are just instantly lock onto you. It's very challenging. That's one thing, good thing about the second game is that they made it more easier in a way, although they added a hard mode, which is literally impossible. I got to like the third level and just gave up. But yeah. Back to the briefcase. Who's there? I can hear you. I know you're there. Now, there's a lot of meaning behind this fight, so once you kill the homeless person, Jacket will puke. This is supposed to, inform the player that he only likes killing Russians. Now, this game takes place in an alternate hit where Russia has nuked San Francisco. And you'll see here, right at the very end, let's see what mark I get. A-. Rasmus mask. Now, what's cool about this is that this is like a hallucination. It's explained in the later games, like in the second game, but this is Jacket's old friend that he used to fight in the war in Hawaii. And so, yeah, he's dead because he got nuked in San Francisco. Spoiler warning.
Really, nigga?
But, yeah, so you'll find that this guy's in all the bars. After every level, you're in a bar and stuff. A bar, a VHS place, and a convenience store. Now, the real person, I forget the guy's name. He actually worked at a convenience store in San Francisco, but yeah. Thank you for subscribing to our newsletter. We appreciate your interest in our cause. America is a tune, and together these must be sung together. The 50 Blessings. Now, the 50 Blessings is like a bunch of masked men who fight the Russian overlords, because Russia is kind of owns the U.S. It's a coalition. So there's many Russian mobsters who moved to the U.S. Oh, oops. I just skipped all that shit. Right away, got a few kids that need to be disciplined. I'm at East 7th Street. make sure you have a long talk with them. I really need someone to get through to them, to these rascals. And like the last time, please be discreet. So, the 50 blessings, I think, are behind the calls. Like, there's these two janitors you'll see later in this game who are doing the phone calls. There's a lot of lore in this game. Okay, we may as well just put this one on. Now, when I first started this game, I kid you not, I could not fucking shoot for the life of me. Auto-aim is much recommended. It is very much so, anyways. But yeah, this is the 50 Blessings logo that you see a lot in the games. And there we go. D+. Also at a pizza shop. Oh, you don't need to order your pizzas. Already done. I had a feeling you were on your way here. Well, let's just leave it at that for now, shall we? Don't worry about paying. It's on the house. But yeah, you can actually just skip these like conversations. You can just go right out and back in your car. Six bodies found on 7th Street. Police suspect ties to illegal drug trade. Jesus. Oh, another. Witness claims seeing monster leaving the scene. Oh, that's it. This is Thomas from the methadone clinic. We've scheduled a short meeting with you tonight. We're at Northwest 184th Street, apartment 105. And don't worry, we know discretion is of importance to our clients. Now, I played the second game, like a newer version, just to kind of get used to the controls again. But, yeah. So that's why I'm not, like, really bad, but, yeah. Anyways. Oh, shit. Yeah, it's gonna happen. But yeah, with this Tony mask, the one character in like the Fanatics, you actually can't pick up weapons, so that's the only good thing about wearing this mask in the first game. Shit, I ran out of ammo. Fuck. Oh my god. Is there a secret in here? I don't know. Yeah, that's a pot. That's just a weapon. It's always good to pick up a gun just in case. Like, sometimes you're tricked on believing the game's, like, the mission's done, but yeah. Sword. Hey dude, good to see you again. Did you hear about the massacre the other night? A bunch of Ruskies, I heard. No loss if you ask me. They say some maniac wearing a rubber mask did it. Sounds like a scene straight from a slasher flick. Oh yeah, I have the perfect film for you. The one on the desk. Take it, it's on the house. Enjoy yourself, dude. But yeah, it's not just Russian gangsters, there's like government officials. I think you kill in the game. Or, no, I think it's just like mobsters. But they have ties to the Soviet Union. About the massacre, another massacre has been reported on Northwest 184th Street. Stirring of gang-related violence throughout Miami. Hi, it's Kate from the Hotline Miami's dating service. We have set up a date for you this evening. She'll be waiting for you at Southwest 53rd Road Place. As usual, make sure you wear something fancy. One of these times, you'll see one of the janitors. Third chapter, Descendants. Sure, let's use this. Fuck. Oh, this has no fucking ammo. What the hell? Oh my god, the fucking door. Dude! Oh my god. That gun in the middle has no ammo. There we go. But yeah, when I first played this game, I literally made it so I wouldn't... Oh, come on. I made it so I only used melee weapons because I could not use the gun for the life of me. Pretty sure I need a shotgun for when I get down there, but I think I used them all. Shit. Damn, that was not smart of me. Yeah, this has no ammo. This guy, you can only take him out with a shotgun. Oh god, please don't! You just gotta kill him. And then you have to take the girl. Yeah, just get over with it. I knew it'd end like this. Well, you show an act of kindness. You filled this lady's bucket by saving her. And then she becomes your girlfriend. I wouldn't say what else. What happened to her? Getting worse. Hi there, welcome. You don't look well, sir. Are you alright? Are you sure it's okay for you to be drinking? Alright. Then I'll get something special. Do you like sweet or sour? Maybe you want it bitter. And there you go. Enjoy, sir. Questions. Oh, it's you again. Looks like you've been busy since we last met. I see that you've remembered me now, don't you? But you still don't know who I am. Don't even know who introduced us, do you? Why did you come back here? You're not a nice person, are you? You make me sick. A picture is starting to take form. I wonder if it's accurate. Some pieces don't quite seem to fit. Or maybe I just don't like the way it looks. I think our time is up. We will meet again. Before you go, here's four questions to ponder. Question number one. Do you like hurting people? Question number two. Who are you? Who are leaving messages on your answering machine? Question number three. Where are you right now? Final question. Why are we having this conversation? That's all for now. See you soon. So, the three masks. The one with, like, the horse. I think it's your girlfriend. Or some lady. The one in the middle. It's his jacket. Mainly his mask talking. And then the third one. The owl. That's a Russian. Like, that's the guy wearing the Russians that you killed. And so, yeah, you'll get conversations with those three every once in a while. Every three missions, I think. Good evening, this is Blake speaking. We have a job for you. There's a power outage over on 24th North Northeast Street. We want you to take care of it. We already sent someone over a while ago, but it seems they didn't do a very good job. Head over there right away. They're expecting you. Keep it quick and clean. So, you'll see your girlfriend just laying on the ground, she's laying here right now, but throughout the game, she'll start cleaning up the apartment, and then you'll notice something with the beds. Movie producer found dead in the villa last night. Surveillance tapes reveal masked assailant. Unidentified female abducted from the scene. Oh, so that big guy who was killed was the movie producer. But it was most likely a rapist. Fuck, I ran out of ammo. That was screwed anyways. Can you melee weapon? Lethal door. Okay, it does work. Okay. Alright, you gotta be very careful with this door. So that's a masked assailant right there. He's one of the other people from 50 Blessings, but once you open this door, it's just gonna explode, so you'll just have to shoot it, but Brace for impact. It's really loud.
Really, nigga?
Never mind. Maybe it wasn't that loud, but when I played this game for the first time, I was not expecting that to be so loud. I went through this door, like I just ran through, and holy shit, my ears were just ringing. Ugh, it's so fucking loud. Yeah, you gotta be careful there too. The reason why I'm not dying as much is because I kinda already know what's gonna happen, but I'm not a pro by any means. Like, you're gonna see me die a lot. I remember things. Let's see what we got. I think I did pretty good this time. B+. Okay, sorry for the interruption. My OBS crashed. Okay, there we go. Alright, so let's just get on to this. Shit! I just skipped the damn phone call. Client at Southwest 104 Street. They seem to have some vermin problems. Try and handle it as quick as and swiftly. Try to handle it as quick and as swift as you can. Someone else will clean up after you leave. Make sure not to bother any of the neighbors. Click. Alright. Jesus. Oh, we forgot the newsletter. Got the little newsletter. Bomb blaster. Heard all the way downtown. Casually still unknown. Charred remains. Several mass suspects witnessed at the... Fifth chapter. Okay, what? Walk fast. This is actually really, really good. These. Especially Rottweilers. I knew someone who had one and it scared the shit out of me every time. Shit. I don't want that. Forgot the guy was there. Yeah, if you're not careful, that guy taking a pistol will just rock your shit. Oops. Fuck. Oh my god. Damn it. Oh, I fucking ran out of ammo. Ugh. I'm alive. Sound good. Don't need that. Now, once you get all the secrets, like, there's like these letters you have to find, but this will open up and you'll find another masked vigilante. I think it's a crocodile. But yeah, that's really cool. Alright, let's go through. Hi, it's Don from the hotel. Hotel Blue. we need you tonight. Our receptionist went home due to stomach problems, and we're having some VIPs who will be staying with us tonight. Make sure to give them a great stay. This will be your top priority this evening. Now get going, click. Okay, so this is the mission where you actually think you'll find the janitors, maybe. Yeah. So it's this person and another person you'll see in the hotel who are the people making the phone calls on behalf of 50 Blessings. So clean head. This is actually a really good mission. Or level. Big mess over by the condos on 122 Street. Oh my god. There's a big mess over by the condos on 122 North Drive Street. So, fucking hell. Neighbors. Boom. Oh my god. There we go. Boom. Oh shit. Oh, I'm stuck on the garbage. Damn it. Okay, once this big guy here goes and cut up there. There we go. Fuck, 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 fuck. Takes one or two shots to kill. Sometimes. Uh-oh. Sometimes it's just easier to take them faster. Are you fucking kidding me? Sometimes it's good just to take the fastest shooting weapon. Fuck! Whoa! Who's alive? Just this guy? Okay. Holy crap. Hey, give me the shotgun. I was totally wrong about the assault rifle. Oh my god, I fucking suck. Oh, I have an assault rifle. What? I got the shotgun. Where's Paul Blart? There we go. Oh, the phone's calling. There's been a small change of plans. We have a prank caller at the telephone company. Why don't you go there and see what you can talk some sense with him, if you know what I mean. 342 North Drive, Southwest Street. Go there now. Floor it. Ugh, look at the massacre. So, the reason, like, this guy here, that's a biker. You play as him later. But, yeah. You're dead meat.
Hey, Super Mario Daniel, don't tell my mod to shut the fuck up, dude.
So, this boss fight was very tricky for me to figure out when I was, like, 4 years ago, or 5 years now. So, you first gotta grab the club, wait for him to throw something at you 3 times. On the third, he's actually gonna throw his knife, and that's when you hit him. Shit, he got me. Yeah, there's a trick to it. Oh shit. Fuck, no. There. Yeah, you can't get him too close to you. There we go, we got him. This can't be happening. It can't end now. Not like this. I'm so close. Well, it did. And there we go. Let's see what we got. Leave this episode off here. We got through a lot, actually. I think we got done through 6 or 7 levels. And yeah, so thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys stick around for the next episode. Have a great day.
We dare awaken the beast who resides under the covers. Do we?